I've always read and heard that Kerala is God's own country. And हमेशा मैं पूछती थी कि नहीं ऐसा क्या है that it is called as God's own country. But the moment you take the first step in the state, you realize yes, it is the God's own country.
So Kerala it was this time, the land of the backwaters, the never-ending slopes of tea gardens, the Kathakali, and the land of the wildlife. We travelled from Mumbai and Delhi respectively, met at Kochi airport and then headed to Munnar, the first in the list for this 5-day trip of ours to Kerala. It takes about roughly 3.5 hours by road to reach Munnar from Kochi. And we were soon bidding adieu to the city life and entering the world of meandering roads, waterfalls and tea gardens of Munnar, also called the Kashmir of South.
Okay, so this is day one and we are en route to Munnar, and of course we've been welcomed with very happy faces here at Kerala. Apart from that, we've also been welcomed by rain, which is why the umbrella. And if you see all around, it's absolutely pleasant weather, a lot of people. What do you have to say?
Actually, it's a beautiful weather. We want to show you here. If you could just turn around a bit. Wow.
If you take a morning flight like we did, you are bound to get hungry before you reach your hotel. Do stop midway, anywhere, and try the authentic Kerala cuisine. Trust me, you'll thank us. I mean, I don't remember the last time I ate like this to my heart's content. Finally, after nearly 4 hours, we reached Munnar and checked into our hotel. You could have the day at leisure if you want, but if you are in Kerala, the land of the Kathakali and the Kalari, the ancient martial art, our advice would be to go watch those performances. Trust us, it's worth any rest. The best moment was when Ipshita was called on stage to perform, and I had a blast recording that moment. Riveting Kathakali was followed by the awe-inspiring martial arts from Kalaripayattu. Based on the fitness of body, mind and soul, the performance indeed had the audience cheering and hooting in admiration. Well, that brings us to the end of our day one in Munnar. Sleeping in the hills, cuddled up in warm beds with raindrops on tin roofs acting as lullabies, is heavenly in itself. And we headed straight for it.
So this is a good morning. When you have a good night, to zahir si baat hai, subah bahut achhi hoti hai. And when you sleep in the tranquil environment of a place as serene, as quiet as Munnar, you are ensured a fresh, happy, good morning. So well, we're all up and set and ready for the sightseeing. We have a lot in store. We're going to go to a national park, which of course is also a UNESCO heritage, and a lot of other sightseeing places. We'll be taking a lot of pictures, recording a lot of videos for you guys to get a better picture of what Munnar is all about. So let's see how the day goes.
We We headed first to the famous Kanam Devi Tea Museum amidst rolling hills dotted with tea plantations all along the way. Set up at the Nalathani Estate, the museum is a tribute to its pioneers who transformed Munnar into a major tea plantation center of Kerala, from the rudimentary tea roller from 1905 to a fully automated tea factory. Visitors and tea lovers can see various stages of the tea processing, crush, tear, curl, and learn about the production of Kerala black tea variants. Tea tasting across different varieties of tea is another attraction, and being tea lovers, we simply couldn't resist the temptation.
You know what? People say you can buy a lot of things with money, but not happiness.
Say who? We just bought a cup of happiness for ourselves because one cup chai ki is equal into a cup of happiness only.
Yes, and especially when you wake up and you are tea connoisseur and you wake up to that freshly brewed cup of tea, it's important to know where it comes from, and today we learn that exactly. So next time when you're in Munnar, please make sure that you visit any of the tea museums and you get to know the story behind how tea came into India, how the plantation and everything started. And of course, every time when you have tea, you nourish and you cherish it and you love it even more, right?
Post our date with freshly brewed tea, we headed to our next destination, the Eravikulam National Park, the first of its kind in Kerala, where the endangered Nilgiri Thar or the mountain goat is protected. One has to buy tickets to get entry into the park, where government buses take you to a certain point. Spread across 97 square kilometers, this park holds the largest viable population of thar, several other species of rare animals, birds and butterflies. The park offers a magnificent view of tea plantations and also of the rolling hills caressed by blankets of mist.
So the bus leads you at a point where you're all by yourself free to explore the nature, and Eravikulam National Park houses a rich diversity of flora and fauna, and we're expecting to see the most of it, but most importantly, the endangered species of South India goat.
It is advised that you should not be touching them. Okay, I was trying my luck on this. Okay, this South Indian goat, also known as the Nilgiri Thar, is endangered species, and more so because an average goat has a lifespan of 10 years, and these goats, their maximum lifespan is only 3 years. So reasons that we should save them, reasons we should preserve them. Hope you're as lucky when you visit the Eravikulam National Park.
Next stop was the rose garden, sprinkled with the bounty of colorful flowers and heartwarming blossoms. For rest of the spots like Eco Point, Photo Point and the Matupattu Dam, rain played spoiled sport for us, but getting to see this in bargain, well, that wasn't too bad a deal. Wanting to get a flavor of the town and also do some shopping, we headed then to the city center. The town manages to have the flavor of the bygone era and is beautiful in its own respect. That brings us to the end of our day 2 in Munnar. Tired bodies but fresh spirits, we headed back to a peaceful night at the hotel. But the way back was so quietly dark and spooky that the CID in us was awake, and we decided to call it a day with some dub smash fun. Well, this was day 1 and day 2 of our visit to Munnar, the first leg of our visit to Kerala, God's own country. I hope you've liked the video and you will also at some point travel along to Munnar and see all the beauty that it has to offer. Do remember to like, subscribe and share to our YouTube channel Travel Along, and also be on a lookout for part 2 of our visit to Thekkady and Kumarakom. Till then,